Includes over 500,000 original drawings, paintings and prints, the third largest collection of watercolour drawings in the UK. We've set out a vision to place this museum at the very heart of the big issues facing humanity in this planet, from eradicating diseases to moderating the impact of climate change. With the support of our many friends and partners, some really exciting things will be happening here in the coming years, to inspire and engage people in these most urgent challenges. Next summer, we will unveil this space that we're standing in now, reimagined, a new Hinsey Hall, complete with a huge blue whale skeleton diving above where you are standing now. I hope that many of you will come back and share that adventure with us. But now, and it is with very great pleasure, I'm pleased to introduce the man who has made tonight possible, Maurice Ostro, Chairman of Ostro Minerals.
Thank you, Sir Michael, for your very generous words. I have to say it would be wrong of me to take any credit for contributing to this institution, because it wasn't my collection, this was my father's stone. I just inherited the collection and his company, and I'm very grateful for that. He was an incredible man, and I'm sure he would be absolutely delighted that his prized stone would end up in one of the greatest mineralogical collections in the world, here in the Natural History Museum. And I think it's great for us Londoners to enjoy and to celebrate this wonderful institution. He was a man which I think it was interesting, an inspiration to me and perhaps to all of us, of what we can do when we realize our own potential, when we push ourselves and we push the boundaries of what we do. To him, pursuing his dreams and going after these incredible stones was something which so inspired him that he would go over any obstacle to achieve his goals, and he didn't mind how he pushed the boundaries, whether it was making blue topaz, which you will see shortly, a far more popular stone than it was decades ago when he started to explore it, and of course it's a very particular and his prized specimen that's going to be unveiled shortly. But it's been a privilege for me to be able to leverage and to use his fantastic connection to help in our philanthropy. And one of the ways that we've done that is looking at new innovative ways of utilizing this incredible collection. And one we're going to explore this evening are some of the beautiful gems that you see that various people are wearing and the artists have created through an initiative that my wife Katie suggested a number of years ago to Candida Gertler, who I'm going to introduce you to shortly, who co-founded Outset, which is a fabulous arts organization, which she will describe to you. But what was really incredible is that if you have something in mind, if you have a goal and you say, this is what I want to do, and you don't mind whatever obstacle and you surmount it, use your innovative thinking, and that's exactly how we're partnering this evening. And one of the great innovations that we see are the things that are happening in the arts. And that, if I wouldn't mind Candida telling us a little bit about that, please welcome Candida Gertler.
Thank you very much, Maurice and Michael, for your warm introductions. I always notice it, that where there's art, there is excitement. And I can't express how excited I am to be here standing with you tonight. Indeed, as Maurice said it, I could tell you loads about Outset, how it started in my living room, and an amazing array of projects that we have been able to realize. It's been realized in the public realm with our community of artists, curators, patrons, partners, teams, and trustees. And some in the room here know that when I start talking about Outset, it's hard to stop me. But don't worry, I will not go on telling you endlessly about Outset. But what I will tell you is that Outset is independent, international, and irresistible. Irresistible as it supports in its rigorous and effective, no messing about way, the treasures of our world, like here in the beautiful Natural History Museum, the artists of our times, and the collections of tomorrow. Our colleagues in 8 different countries, of which all are represented here tonight, do so by relying on wonderful patrons and partners like Katie and Maurice Ostro. Like-minded, we truly believe that our cultural institutions, like the one we're standing in tonight, deserve our affection, dedication, and support. Yes, our generation's talent and our ancestors' legacies deserve our attention. So thank you to the Ostro family for the wonderful gift you are making tonight and the creative way you are launching this gift into the future by enabling wonderful artists to create new pieces of wearable art. I could not be more thrilled about the incredibly exciting fusion of tonight's event. And I could not be more proud of the beautiful jewellery created by Isaac Julian, Nicole Vermers, and Catherine Ness. They're setting out to follow in the incredible steps of the doyen of wearable art, Calder. And it is my great privilege to first thank you all for being here tonight, but also to pass on to wearable art expert, Louisa Guinness. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Canada. Well, as I have such a captive audience, and I thought for the next 45 minutes while you're all standing here, I would tell you a little bit about a wearable art, but don't worry, just kidding. I'm here really, I'm just thrilled to be invited to co-host this with Maurice in Canada to bring the circle together. This is about topaz, gemstones, about art, and about jewellery. And many people have asked me this evening, sort of, so what's it all about? What are we doing? So we're unveiling the most fantastic topaz. We're showing you some jewellery that has been made by 3 fantastic artists, which is supported by Outset, which Canada runs. Nicole Vermers, who's made this ring that I think wearing it? Yes, Canada's wearing the ring. And Vanessa, where's Vanessa? Vanessa's over here. She's wearing the piece that's been made by Isaac Julian, which is also using the topaz, which Maurice has kindly donated. And Catherine Yass's piece is being worn by Young's going to have a senior moment. Malcolm. Where's Malcolm?
He's coming.
Okay, so you'll see Malcolm later, and he's wearing a topaz that pulsates. It's actually got a light inside it, which makes it go boom, and it's amazing. So that's the first important piece about the topaz and the link between the jewellery and the artists. The second, and from my part, as the sort of most keen, passionate person about blending art with jewellery, is to thank Janine Harrington, who has, where is she, organised the performance artists, and Elise Overland, who's designed all the costumes. You may have noticed these incredible people making the Alexander Calder jewellery move. So Calder, as you may know, is one of the greatest artists of all time. Made mobiles. He also made a lot of jewellery. And his desire was that the jewellery was worn and that it moved like mobiles. And so this is what we have tried to present to you. So this is just a little introduction to the world of artists. Picasso made jewellery, Max Ernst made jewellery, Calder made jewellery, Anish Kapoor made jewellery. There are lots of people out there, but I'm not going to spend hours telling you about it. Please have a look in this little blue book which you can take home with you on the way out. It tells you all about the new pieces that have been made. It tells you about some of the other artists who have made jewellery. And I just hope that you will continue to follow us and that maybe Maurice will continue to support artists who made jewellery and give more people a chance, which I'm hoping, I think he will, to make more jewellery. So without further ado, that's my question.
A collaboration with, for those of you who are familiar with the My Fair Share Foundation, there's a number of things that we're very passionate about. One of them is collaboration. There's a building not far from here with 16 different charities all working in the same area. And one of the things we try to do is ensure they have the maximum impact, and they do that by working together in the same areas. We also want to launch very shortly a fantastic campaign for entrepreneurial giving, which is to get entrepreneurs to put passion and to put purpose and mission into the core of their new enterprises. And one of the things, there are a number of people here who have been very helpful in that regard, and one of the things we will try to do is not only to inspire people to be more philanthropic, but also that they should be more innovative in the way that they give. And the innovations, as I say, even here in the museum, when this is all finished, it's not ready yet because the stone is going to be just here, we're going to be unveiling in a moment. Upstairs in the mineralogical gallery, you will see that in spite of the 130-year history of cabinetry which they've had, the museum has agreed to make a state-of-the-art display case because of this particular gemstone. We're very grateful to the trustees of the museum, to Sir Michael, who spoke to us, to Mike Rumsey and Claire Gilfie and her teams, as well as Alan Hart, who was the person who first suggested bringing the stone here. My thanks again to Candida Alcet, to Louisa for making this activity so much more impactful, and all of you are enjoying this evening some fantastic champagne from Laurent Perrier. You'll soon have some fantastic chocolate from Prestat, and another great institution down the road. I don't know if some of you noticed the Harrods logo as you came in. Harrods very kindly agreed to support another local institution because they thought it was such a wonderful thing to provide this stone, and they themselves have some very unique pieces that are one of their kind. And my final gratitude has to be to the performers you're now about to hear. To Animatronic, who's come from New York to arrange the music. And if you missed it, you were listening to her music beforehand, and you will be shortly after the unveiling. But without further ado, we would like to introduce to you Daphne Guinness and her band. Please welcome them for the music and for the unveiling of the stone. Enjoy.